गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स. सो आफ्टर वंडरफुल प्रेजेंटेशन 5 बाय बाला सर ऑन पीपी इन नॉन कोविड पेशेंट, आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट यूज ऑफ पीपी इन कोविड पॉजिटिव पेशेंट, एस्पेशली इन आइसोलेशन वार्ड, आईसीयू एंड ऑपरेशन थिएटर. These are the two references which I used to prepare this presentation. One is by Canadian guideline and another is WHO recommendation about rational use of PPE during severe shortages. So, on 11th of March, WHO declared COVID as pandemic, and since then we are getting daily cases in thousands and lakhs. At present, there are more than 30 lakhs patients who are COVID positive and more than 2 lakhs patients died because of this illness. Infection rate in healthcare worker is unfortunately very high. This is because of direct exposure of healthcare workers to the COVID patients. So infection rate is high, and even deaths, there are many deaths of unfortunate deaths of healthcare worker during this COVID scenario. So PPE is the most important thing to prevent this infection to healthcare worker. Other laymen can get rid of COVID by remaining at home, by taking proper hand hygiene or by wearing mask. But we need proper PPE because we are directly exposed to the COVID patient. But at the same time, rational use of PPE is important looking at demand supply ratio. Countries like US, UK, Italy and other European countries are struggling to get enough PPE for their healthcare workers. So we have to use it rationally to prevent short supply. If I talk a bit about how it happens, infection spread through the mucous membrane by droplet and aerosol containing the virus, and it also spread through the fomite which stays on the surface of any surface like and it can spread. It is a potential source of infection for longer duration. So if you look at the respiratory droplets, there are various types like large infectious droplet. It travels for 1 to 3 feet, but smaller infection droplets which can be spread through coughing or sneezing, they travel up to 3 to 5 feet, and that's why it is advisable to stay away 2 meters from the patients whenever possible. And smaller infection droplet nuclei, they are less than 5 microns, can travel through air, and we don't know whether it is traveling through the air or not. So, but we have to take precaution against it also. So, what is the rational use of PPE in COVID positive patients? We need to use it in isolation ward where they are kept with mild symptom. We need to be more cautious in ICU and OT. I will not cover OT part, but it is more or less same. It will be covered by Gopal sir in next presentation. Selection of PPE is very important. Appropriate PPE depend on the exposure risk, separated into 3 types. First is contact and droplet precaution. Second is airborne, droplet and contact precaution when there are chances of smaller droplets, and third is precaution for high risk aerosol generating medical procedures. So according to that, there are 3 types of PPE. Like if it is not aerosol generating procedure and you are not close to the patient, you can wear the N95 mask, you can wear proper gown and gloves and shoe cover and get away with it. But if you are close, if you are in the environment where such procedures are going on like intubation or tracheostomy or bronchoscopy, then you have to cover your face and head with a face shield and headgear. You have to wear goggles so that you your eye don't get contaminated. And if you are performing such procedure, then you have to go for full-fledged PPE. Like you have to wear a coverall apron, you should wear hood with face cover and a neck cover. You have to wear double gloves. Double gloves are important. There are studies where they say that with double gloves, chances of infection is less. So according to the type of your exposure, you have to select your PPE so that there won't be scarcity of PPE in future. Donning and doffing. It is about wearing and removing the PPE. This is very important. If you don't do it properly, you will be exposed to virus and you will be contaminated with virus and you can get the disease. Especially doffing is very important. It should be supervised by some other person when we are doing donning and doffing so that we can do it properly. And there must be some guidelines stuck to the wall of the donning and doffing room so that you can watch it and wear your PPE in a proper manner. Like initially you have to put on scrubs, put on shoe cover, then wash hand, then put on N95. So this is a sequence, and accordingly doffing is also sequence. There are many videos of donning and doffing on YouTube and other social media. You can watch it, and there are guidelines according to the type of PPE. There are various type of PPE, and they give specific instruction how to don and doff, and you should follow that. So if you look at the basic minimum principles of PPE, first and most important, protect healthcare provider through appropriate PPE. Like category 1, 2 and 3 I described earlier, you have to wear it. There is no one ideal PPE. There are various type of PPE in market, so you have to get used to those PPE. Sometimes you are getting one type of PPE because of scarcity or short supply of that PPE, you will get different type, then go for training for that another PPE and be careful while using it. There are some homemade combination of PPE, but it should not be used without approval from appropriate authority, otherwise you will expose yourself to coronavirus. During high risk aerosol generating medical procedure, decrease exposure of healthcare provider by limiting those present to the essential provider only. Suppose you if you are intubating a COVID positive patient in the OT, no one should be there inside OT till 20 minutes. You and your assistant will intubate the patient with all precaution, all PPE, and one person who can help you if required should be there outside the OT with all PPE on. So in case of emergency, he or she can come inside and help you. And most experienced person should do this procedure so that chances of failure are less and you can do it in it as fast as possible. There are currently no specific measure recommended for self-contamination during the doffing procedure occurs. Suppose some self-contamination occurs during doffing or while doing procedure, then there are no specific guideline, but you have to wash your hand. You have in certain hospital they advocate to take shower with soap after doffing so that viral load can be reduced if at all it occurs. Track and protect PPE supply. There must be someone who can help you to get continuous supply of the PPE. Promote scalable generalized innovation in accordance with the institutional policy. You can have some innovation, but be careful. It should be according to the institutional policy. Otherwise, there are chances of, if at all something goes wrong, you will be blamed. Donning PPE should be in accordance with the institutional guidelines. There must be someone to assist you or guide you while you are donning and doffing, especially in the initial period. Pay attention to how you don to augment your ease of doffing. So if you pay attention while donning, then doffing will be easy, like putting on N95 mask first, then you should remove it at last. So pay attention, don't get distracted while donning and doffing. That will increase chances of contamination. Contamination of healthcare provider can occur either in the patient room or during doffing process. Doffing PPE or PPE removal is a high risk procedure because of risk of cell contamination, so it should be done under supervision. Surgical mask or N95 respirator should be last item to be removed. PPE donning and doffing require education and practice, so it should be a continuous process. And hand hygiene performed throughout the donning and doffing process should be done according to the local guideline. So it is very important to maintain hand hygiene while doing it. But there are many unanswered questions. This is how we do use PPE, but we don't know how many cases will be there by end of the May. Recently, a collector from Ahmedabad told that if cases double every 4 days, then there will be 8 lakh cases only in Ahmedabad by end of the May. So we have to be careful. Do we have adequate infrastructure to handle this many patients? Will there be enough supply of PPE? That's why we need to use optimize use of PPE according to WHO guidelines, and this is not my guidelines. This is by WHO, and they tell that there are all chances that there will be scarcity of PPE and you should be careful. So they said that we should minimize PPE in it, use PPE appropriately, and coordinate PPE supply chain so that it so that you get proper and adequate PPE. To minimize use of PPE, telemedicine is advocated for mild symptom patient or asymptomatic patient. Keep them at home and keep in contact with them daily with telephonic talk or video call, so that you are not exposed to those patient and you can prevent use of PPE. No elective surgery. This is very important for all of anesthetists. Elective surgery should be postponed till COVID goes down, because you are exposing yourselves and your patient to the COVID infection by doing elective surgery. Designate dedicated team for extended use of PPE. There should be a dedicated team of certain members who will do duty in the COVID specific area, so that reduce number of staff, reduce number of PPE. Restrict healthcare member entry to the room and ward. Restrict the entry to the minimum to reduce the usage of PPE. Use minimum PPE if no close contact is done. Like if you are explaining something to the patient, then stay away 2 meters away from the patient. Use minimum PPE like N95 mask and gown and gloves, and you can avoid using complete PPE. Restrict entry of visitor, otherwise you will have to provide PPE to them also. Rational use of PPE is important. Use according to the setting and activity and indication. Choose proper PPE like category 1, 2, 3 according to the type of procedure. Decision making in case of severe shortage. If such things happen, this is the cartoon by Ganesh Chaudhary, and I am thankful to him for this cartoon. Like if press people or politician will start using PPE, then definitely we healthcare person will not have PPE. So we need to go for PPE extended use, reprocessing and reuse, and considering some alternate items. But be careful. Each of these measures carries significant risk and limitation, and thus should be considered only as a last resort. I repeat, it is as a last resort when all other strategies for rational and appropriate use and procurement of PPE have been exhausted. So this should be as last resort, otherwise follow the proper guideline. Extended use of PPE, there are certain risks with it. Extended use of medical mask may increase risk of contamination of mask with COVID-19 virus and pathogen. And wearing the mask for a prolonged period may increase the chance of the healthcare worker touching the mask or having inadvertent under mask touches if the mask is touched or adjusted, and hygiene must be done. Damage or to the reaction to the face skin occur with prolonged use. Filtration media of mask may become clogged, thereby increasing breathing resistance and the risk of breathing unfiltered ambient air from the side of the mask. So if mask is clogged, air will come through the side of the mask and you will get exposed. Extended period of time in active patient ward required for healthcare worker. This is exhausting physically as well as mentally to the healthcare worker. Removal criteria should be followed, like if the mask become wet, soiled or damaged, it should be removed. If the mask is exposed to the splash of chemical, infectious substance or body fluids, if the mask is displaced from face for any reason, then it should be replaced. If the front of the mask is touched, to adjust it, follow the same procedure for removal and do not touch the front of the mask. The mask need to be removed whenever providing care outside a designated area. So this should be followed for masks, gowns and everything. Reprocessing and reuse. There are certain techniques coming up like H2O2 vaporization, UV radiation, moisture incubation, using four masks in a paper bag, which is recommended by AIIMS, that they provide four masks to the healthcare person. One mask used today will be used after 4 days. It should be kept in a paper bag in an isolation area. Keep it there for 4 days, then you can reuse it. You can do such innovation, like this is the intubation chamber prepared by us. Ganga Hospital had added something like negative pressure to it and use of sterile hand cover while doing intubation. So you can innovate such things so that you don't get viral exposure. These are the dimension of the intubation box. You can prepare at your place with acrylic material and it protects. And you can even use this without a video laryngoscope. Video laryngoscope is advocated with along with this so that you are away from the patient. But you, even if you don't have a video laryngoscope, you can use it. This is the face shield locally made. You can use it to protect yourself, or else you can use such helmets. So you can do such innovation, but you should know the limitation of this innovation and you should act accordingly. This is the gown prepared from impervious material. You can use it when there is shortage of PPE in your hospital. And these are the shoe cover. These are also reusable, made of impervious material. You can properly sterilize it after usage and you can reuse it. So these are the innovation. You can do it in case of severe scarcity of PPE supply. So safety of healthcare worker is most important thing, but we don't know when we will have severe scarcity. So we will have to prepared for the worst. I wish and I pray that it won't come, but it can come anytime. Like in US, they have case 10 lakh cases and 50,000 deaths. If it can happen in your country like US, it can happen anywhere. So be prepared with alternate options. We are like soldiers on border in battle against corona, so we have to fight it with it. Proper preparation will help us to win this battle against corona. So this is all about it. Jai Hind, Namaste. Thank you.